Kali Linux in the cloud for free. In this video, I'm gonna walk you through it. We're gonna throw Kali Linux, the best Linux hacking distro, up into the cloud on AWS, which if that doesn't sound cool, then why are you even here? So seriously, we're gonna walk through it super fast. And it's actually pretty simple. I'm gonna walk you through setting up a free AWS account and then getting that server spun up. And not just command line, we're gonna have GUI access. So if having Kali in the cloud available all the time with a public IP sounds awesome, then let's keep going. And shout out to the sponsor of this video, Privacy. They basically allow us to virtualize our
payment cards,
and we're actually gonna use them to set up our AWS accounts. Okay, we're going fast. What do you need? First, coffee, so we can go even faster. Hurry, sip. Next, you'll need a computer. I'll be demoing this on Windows and Linux, so that'll cover pretty much everyone, including Mac people. And finally, you'll need an AWS account, Amazon Web Services. I'm gonna walk you through setting up a free tier account, which won't charge you a dang thing, unless you go over the free tier stuff. And to do this, you will need a credit card. Thankfully, the sponsor of this video, Privacy, makes this super easy. Okay, get your coffee. Woo, let's do this. Okay, now let's get our AWS account set up. Launch your favorite web browser. And here in Google, I'm just gonna search for AWS free tier. I also have a link below if you wanna use that. And I'll click that first link here, AWS free tier, easy for me to say. And right here, I'll click create free account. Here, you don't need my help with this. Just put in your stuff, email address, password, all that stuff. Click continue. For most of us, this will be a personal account. So go ahead and select that radio button real quick, go. And then more stuff you don't need my help with, your name and stuff. And then agree blindly to all terms and click continue. And then here's that dreaded credit card number they look for. Again, if we stay within the free tier boundaries, you will not be charged. And for this example, for this demo, we're gonna do Kali Linux in the free tier, so no worries. Now for my credit card, I'm gonna use privacy.com. I'm gonna use Privacy to create a virtual credit card that I can use within AWS. Let's do it, get logged in. And then I'll click on create a card, creating a virtual card that ties back to my actual debit card. I'll name it AWS. Save, and then I can put a limit in. So in case I do go over my free tier, which I do worry about, I can say, you know what? Limit it to $5 a month. That's it, which is totally cool, right? So set my $5 spending limit, create my card, and boom, just like that, a virtual card. I love this because I can turn this card on and off when I need to, in case AWS is going crazy on me. Just gonna copy and paste the info here. And you can do that with any service, which is so cool. Netflix, networkchuck.coffee, which I had in here as well. And if we click continue and move on to AWS support, privacy.com is just like AWS support on their basic side anyway. They are free. I love free, which is what I want to choose right here. So we try out Privacy. You can use it for this purpose right now. They do have a premium tier, which gives you extra goodies. And if you're a business, you can do some really cool stuff like controlling how much your employees spend per card. Anyways, check them out. Link below, privacy.com/networkchuck. You can use it for this exact purpose. Anyways, let's continue. My account's ready. I'm going to click on complete sign up. Let's do this. Little coffee break. Whew. Congrats, AWS, I am here. They're activating my account. Take a few minutes. Cool, let's go to the AWS management console and see if it's ready. Probably won't be just yet. I'm gonna try to get logged in. Do root user, my email address I used before. Next, and then my password. And then it's gonna do me, oh wait, gotta do a CAPTCHA first. Gosh, I hate these so much. Anyway, submit, and then my password. Dang, that was fast, my account's ready. Let's do this, okay. Okay, first we're gonna focus on launching a virtual machine. So we'll go down here and click on launch a virtual machine with EC2, which is what AWS calls their virtual machine service. Click that. Then over here on the left, we're gonna select AWS Marketplace. Select that, and then up here in the search terms, we're gonna search Kali. And there it is, right there. So cool that you can do this in AWS, right? Oh my gosh. So from here, I'll select Kali. Click on select. It's gonna tell you how much things cost. Ignore that for now, because we're gonna be in free tier. Click on continue. And then finally, we'll select our tier. The guy you want is right here, T2.micro, free tier eligible. Select that guy. That's pretty much it. We're gonna click on review and launch. Go. And one more time, we're gonna click on launch. Now here with AWS, instead of using a password to access your Kali Linux box, it's gonna use an SSH key pair. We're gonna need one. Right now, I don't have one. It's screaming at me, no key pairs found. No worries, you and I can create one right now just by selecting this first drop-down box and saying create a new key pair. I'll name this Kali, and then click on download key pair. Now that's important, you wanna make sure you do that. Save it, bam. Do not lose that file, otherwise you won't be able to access Kali. But now with our key pair created, we can click on launch instances. Click it, go, fast. Oh, coffee break. Oh, don't you just love doing stuff like this? The cloud, we're in the cloud, we're putting stuff in the cloud. Now you may get a message like this, like I have right here. Don't worry, it does go through after a moment. Just more time for a coffee break, man. Whew. But I'm getting antsy, so I'm gonna go check on my subscription status, which again is not a paid subscription. It's a free thing that we're just subscribing to Kali Linux in the marketplace. Kali Linux is free, but we still have to subscribe to it. no worries. It's kind of like subscribing to my YouTube channel, which you should do if you haven't already done so. Do that right now. And actually, it looks like it's already done. Access level agreement, I'm solid. So to find my new Kali Linux box, we're gonna go up here to services and our menu, click that drop down, and then over here under compute, we're gonna click on EC2. And then underneath instances, we'll click on, well, instances. Kind of hard to say, instances. Okay, click on it right there. All right, nothing yet, it's still cooking. No worries, time for a coffee break. Okay, I sat here and refreshed this for a while until I realized that maybe it's not here, and it wasn't. You see, AWS is a cloud provider that has data centers everywhere. The one I'm in right now, I can tell from at the top, I'm in North Virginia. That's where I'm looking at, and right now I have no instances or virtual machines in that region. So I thought maybe I accidentally created it in another region, like maybe US East or Ohio. Let's jump in there. Sure enough, there it is. So it went there. So if you don't see yours, jump into a different region. And also, by the way, if you wanna create this virtual machine in another region that's closer to you, they everywhere, man. Anyways, there is my beautiful virtual machine. What do you say we jump inside? Let's do it. Click on that instance ID. Oh yeah. Now what we care about right now is the IP address. We have it, let's get connected. So here in Windows, I'm gonna launch my Windows terminal, CMD, and also I need to make sure I copy that IP address. From here, I'm gonna change directories into my downloads folder, because that's where I have my key I'm gonna use to connect to my Kali box. So CD downloads, I'm there. And now, time to SSH into our box. So SSH, I'll then do a space and a dash I or tick I, and then a space, and then I'll put in my key that I have, which I know is called kali.pem. That's my credentials. Then I'll type in kali at, and then paste in the IP address. Now, just to recap what's happening here, we're using SSH secure shell to connect to our Kali box in the cloud. With dash I, we're specifying that we're using the kali.pem SSH key to authenticate us. And then over here, we're saying we're using the username kali to connect to this box right here, our Kali box. All that's left now is to hit enter. Type in yes to accept that unknown fingerprint, and boom. Yes, we're in. We're in Kali, command line, that's cool. But it's in the cloud, man, how cool is that? And by the way, that command we just used to connect is the same on Linux and Mac. Let me show you. I'm actually gonna demonstrate on another Kali box to connect to Kali. I'll use that same command as before, paste that in there, yes sir, and I'm in. Love it. And I'm gonna say it again, don't lose that file, don't lose that key. If you don't have the key, you can't get in, just like your house. I'm gonna stay in Linux because it's really pretty. I love it here. Now at this point, you have the working Kali Linux box, albeit it's only through the command line. You may want a GUI. I love GUIs too. Let's create a GUI and let's connect to it over VNC. And securely, we're gonna use SSH to securely connect to our box here over VNC to get that nice, beautiful GUI. Let's do it right now. First, we're gonna do a sudo apt update to update our repositories. Now with our repositories updated, we're going to install our GUI and typevnc to make it a typevnc server. The command will be sudo apt install, and these commands will all be below, by the way, xfce4 space xfce4 dash goodies, and then space typevnc server, all one word. So we're installing three things all at once. Ready, set, go. Woo-hoo-hoo. Oh, wait, hit enter. Then we're good, coffee break, yes. Let's take a bit. Now, while this is cooking, just a couple things you might want to know. This installation of Kali is going to be very bare bones. It may not have all the tools you will be looking for. Easy to solve that. Couple commands. You can do apt install kali-linux-full. This will install everything you could ever want. Takes forever, but if you want all the tools, go for it. An alternate would be something like this. Apt install kali-linux-top10, which will simply install the top 10 security tools that you might care about. Okay, that took a minute, but not too long. Mine is done. Just a few more things we have to install. This command right here, I'm gonna paste it in. We're installing GNOME Core, a Linux desktop, some Kali defaults, desktop stuff. Anyways, it's all good. Press enter. Oh wait, we gotta be root. There we go. Sudo access, hit enter. Yes, go. More coffee break. When prompted, choose GDM3 or LightDM. I like LightDM, hit enter. That also took a minute, but anyways, we're almost done. Just one more thing we have to do here, and then we can connect to it via the GUI. Woo, here we go. We're gonna configure our typevnc server. So type in typevnc server, space tick geometry. I hated geometry in school. And then type in 1024 by 768. Enter. Now you're gonna set a password to access this box via VNC. One more time. View only password, nah, I'm good. Bam, it's ready, it's ready. Okay, how do we connect? First, let's make sure it's actually running. So I'm gonna type in netstat-tulpn, T-U-L-P-N. There it is, running on port 5901. Yes. So now let's get connected. Now for that, I'm gonna switch back to Windows because it'll be more impressive to do it from Windows. First, I'll launch a command prompt, and this will be the same on Mac as well. I mean, and Linux, yeah. So launch a terminal. Same thing as before, I wanna get into the same directory where I have my key, which was downloads for me. And then type in this command, SSH -capital L 5901:localhost:5901 --n --f, and that n was capital, by the way. Then your server information, so we'll start with Callie, which is the username, at his IP address, which I forgot. Let me go grab it. There it is. Paste that in there. And then finally, we'll do a -i and specify our key, which mine was called callie.pim. Now real quick, what's happening here? This is setting up a secure SSH tunnel to your Kali Linux box in the cloud. We'll use that tunnel to VNC over that sucker to access it securely. But we need that tunnel created, and that's what this command does. So enough talking, let's hit enter, and it did it. I mean, I feel like it's just doing it, but it's done, it's doing it. So minimize that. Now we need a tool to VNC into this. So I'm just gonna go look for a VNC, it's called VNC Viewer, yes. Real VNC, Windows, click on that, download it, run it, okay. Next, yeah, next, next, install, yes. And finish. Okay, you know how installs work. Anyways, here we go. Now to launch it. This is taking forever, VNC. Come on, VNC Viewer. I'll simply type in up here at the top, localhost:5901, and hit enter. Click continue. Put in your password that you set earlier, your VNC password. Click OK. Yes, yes, look at this. I'm in Windows, and I'm VNC'd, or remotely accessing, Kali Linux in the cloud on AWS. Powerful. How cool is that? Over a secure SSH tunnel. Now, the reason I used localhost as the address to access this is because that's what I specified here in my command. That's what we have running right now, which, by the way, you have to run that every time we go to VNC into our Kali Linux box. But hey, man, the price you gotta pay for security. Isn't she beautiful? The process will be the same on Linux and Mac. Just make your SSH tunnel. Made. And then opening up another command prompt, I'll use my VNC viewer, specify localhost, port 5901, hit enter, it'll ask me for my VNC password, and boom, just like that. Kali Linux on Kali Linux, Kali Linux inception. That was kind of hard to say. Anyways, that's it. Kali Linux in the cloud, AWS, and you get a GUI. Now, why do this? Well, first, it's free, as long as you stay within the free tier. And if you use privacy, you can restrict how much money you get charged, which can be like a dollar if you want. Second, it's a machine that's always on in the cloud and has a public IP address, which is killer if you're trying to learn some hacking skills. Also, in the cloud, you can add other machines, vulnerable machines, Windows and stuff that you can practice with. You can create your own lab environment in the cloud. And also, it's just cool to learn AWS and Kali Linux all at the same time. Both killer skills you can put on your resume. But yeah, that's all I got today, guys. If you haven't already, hack that YouTube algorithm. Like this video, comment, subscribe, notification bell. Yeah, that's all. You gotta hack YouTube today. Ethically, of course. Yep, that's it. I'll catch you guys next time.